trying to. Coming to you again with another kingdom, talk, power, authority session. Thank you for being us, Global Diplomat College Center. Global Diplomat College Center vision is transforming students into leaders, leaders and agents of change. I want to focus on what I believe shall be the keys of kingdom living in the year 2020. Our focus topic is repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Matthew 4:17. Jesus Christ's first inaugurated message. He addressed the mind. Repent, define, change of heart, change of mind, change the way you live, change your life. Why? For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It's arrived. In other words, the kingdom of heaven is right here now. Am I making myself clear? We are being deceived. We are being misled. We've been miseducated by Christianity, by many religious body groups, who now the largest religious organization in the world. But this message has been hid for 1800 years. Repent, for the kingdom is at hand. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heaven is a kingdom. It is the domain of God. God is the king of heaven. Earth is a colony of heaven. In the book of Isaiah 6, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. The Bible, Jesus, God promises a government. Jesus never promises dictatorship nor socialist nor democratic nor democracy. There are many forms of government, but Jesus promises a kingdom government. God promises a kingdom government. And this is the government I want to explain to you about. It's been hid for 1800 years. Christianity refused to preach it. Denomination refused to preach it. But it's the only message Jesus preached. For unto us a child is born. That child is Jesus. Unto us a son is given. Mary birthed the child. God gave to Son. Jesus Christ brought a government. It's called the government. That's what the world is suffering from, government. There are so many chaos in democracy. There are racism. There are folks burning Bible, burning flag, folks civil disobedience. Many country in chaos, economical, social ills that confronted many country, many families around the world. The government do not know what to do. Jesus Christ brought a government. It's an invisible government. Ambassador, explain to me more about heaven's government. Heaven's government came down. When Jesus came down to earth, he brought that government with him. That is a government from the time of Adam, of our father. God gave Adam a government. God said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness, let them have government. Dominion is government. Rule, world power, kingship, leadership, control. Let them have kingdom, dominion, leadership right here on this earth. In other words, Adam is the administrator, the king of the earth. You now, me now, are the administrator, the king of the earth. We are the original king. I invite you, I extend that you will pursue and enter into the government of the kingdom. The government of the kingdom is called the kingdom of God. Jesus brought a government, and the government shall be on him, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. There are no peace in the world. Palestine and Israel and many nations at war, there are no peace. In other words, they don't have a settled peace in the Middle East. No peace in family, no peace in the country. They're war against Democratic and Republic. They're war against family and nation, nation against nation, country against country. There are many wars, presidents, prime minister, start amongst each other. There are trade wars, there are economical war, there are corona war. There are many wars that are confronted. There are no peace. Peace is quietness and quantity. Peace is calm. Peace is when you know everything is solved, when you know your economy is solved, when you know your life is solved, when you know your children and everything's been taken care of. You have peace and quietness and quantity, economical peace, social peace. You have peace and quietness, not chaos, not crime. The earth is full of crime and evil in democracy. Many racism, there are wars and racism. People don't have no justice. But their government will bring peace. He's called Prince of Peace. In the world, you never have peace. Jesus made a statement, in me, you'll have peace. But in the world, you'll have tribulation. The world is the order of authority. Order, system of government. You have wars, chaos. Am I making myself clear? Of the increase of his government. The government that God promised is the government is the kingdom of God. And peace, there shall be no end. Upon the throne of David, upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom to order it, to establish it, with judgment and with justice. From henceforth, forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts. The word host is the Lord army. will perform this. This is a government that is right here now. I am an ambassador of that government, heaven's government, kingdom government. I'm a settler on the earth, but many citizens are citizens on earth of heaven government. In other words, we are citizens of a kingdom. That kingdom is an invisible kingdom. It's called the kingdom of God. The Pharisees and scribes, they did not understand about a kingdom. They inquire, they sought, they pursued Jesus and asked him, when will the kingdom of God come? Jesus replied, the kingdom of God come not with observation, but the kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is within your heart. Inside, an invisible government, an invisible king. Yes, you can burn Bibles. Yes, you can burn churches. You can destroy, but you cannot destroy the kingdom. The kingdom of God is forever. In other words, the location of the kingdom is in heaven. From the invisible, from the unseen to the seen. What is a kingdom? A kingdom is a government led by a king. Who's this government? The citizen on earth. Kingdom citizen. Who is this king? Lift up your head, O gates. Be lifted up, ye everlasting door. And let who? The King of glory come on in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. I'd like to explain more about the kingdom government. The kingdom government has an army. It's called hosts, the angels. Thousands of ten thousands of angels. It's called the army of God. Christians and the church is not the army. The army are the angel, invisible. Am I making myself clear? The government have lost lifestyle, culture. In other words, love is a culture of the kingdom of God. Peace is a culture of the kingdom of God. Glory is the culture of the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God, it is the influence of the earth. Let your light so shine before man. That light is knowledge, that they may see your good works. That means the good works of Jesus Christ living through the hearts of a citizen, colonizing and influencing the earth. Let the knowledge of God so shine that they will see your good works and glorify. Give God the Father glory. Hallelujah. I am so happy and glad that I am in the care of government of God. How can you become and receive the kingdom? How can you get in the government now? Matthew 6:33. But seek ye first. The most important thing in your life is to seek ye first. The what? The kingdom and his righteousness. And all these things that you need shall be added to you. Seek ye first. Your first priority is to seek ye first the kingdom, not a religion, but seek ye first the kingdom of God, and everything that you need, it shall be added to your life. That's Matthew 6:33. The word seek means to inquire. The word seek means to investigate, to prove what I'm telling you is true. Seek it out for yourself. Seek, and you go and find the word kingdom. Find the word government. You'll see for yourself. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things shall be added on to you. Am I making myself clear? The government of the kingdom of God have arrived. It's right here now. I invite you and I extend an invitation to you that you get in the government of the kingdom of God. Am I making myself clear to you? The government of the kingdom of God has arrived. It's right here now. The first question about the government, Matthew 6:25. Jesus made a statement, "Therefore I say unto you, take no thoughts of your life, for what you eat or what you shall drink, or your for your body." The number one issue and chaos and ill in our world is worry, stress. Thousands of people and millions of people around the earth are stressed out. Stressed out with bills. Stressed out with house note, car note, children for school fees and versions. They're stressed out with many ills and economical crises and corona crises and many crises of the economy. They're stressed out. Do not worry about your life. Therefore, I say to you, you shall not take no thought, worry, for what you, of your life, what you shall eat, what you shall drink, or what yet for your body, what you shall put on. Is not life more than meat, and the body more than raiment? Behold the birds that fly every day. Behold the birds of the air. They sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barn. Yet your heavenly Father, the King, take care of them. And why take ye thought and worry about garment? Consider the lily of the valley, how they grow, they toil not, nor they spin. And yet I say unto you that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which is today and tomorrow cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Therefore take no thoughts of saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or what shall we clothe? For all these things the heathen, the Gentile, seek after. All these things they seek after. Shelter, food, clothes, water. All these things, car, boat, houses, land. All these things they pursue after. But seek ye first the kingdom of God. And all these things, all these worry shall be added to you. In the kingdom government, the king is responsible for your finance, for your housing, for your health, for your life, for your clothes, for your shoes. He's concerned about everything in your life. God is concerned. God is the creator. God is the manufacturer. He's the one that he made you. You are his product. You bear his name. Once you bear his name, he are committed to his name. You are responsible. So return, rediscover kingdom of God government in your life. The government of democracy is failing around the world. The only government going to stand is the kingdom. And the kingdom is an everlasting government. It's from generation to generation to generation to generation. Am I making myself clear? This is Joseph God Holy Prophet and Ambassador. Until next session, may God bless you. May God make his face shine upon you and give you peace. This is the time when you can get back in the kingdom government. Thank you again for viewing us in our channel, our Global Diplomat College Center. I appreciate all the subscribers, the viewers, and also our pastors of Global Diplomat College Center, Pastor Elvie of Global Diplomat College Center, Antipolo City, Manila, Philippines, Pastor Jason Webbs and his wife. Pastor of Global Diplomat College Center, United States of America, and India, all the folks we have in India, all the folks that are in the Bahamas, Nassau, Bahamas, Freeport, Bahamas, thank you for all of your support. Thank you all of you for supporting this great ministry, and the Philippines, Manila, Philippines, and other countries. And most of all, we thank the United States of America. May God bless you. Bless your family. This is Joseph, God Holy Prophet, Ambassador. Till next session.